I gotta say, last time I saw you, I think it was the last time I saw you, was at Howard Stern's 60th birthday party?
Yes, which was a surprisingly inspiring evening.
Gosh, was it inspiring?
Okay, I went in, you know, excited for the spectacle. I didn't think I was gonna cry with joy and be so moved by his life's work and his relationship with Robin Quivers. I lost it.
Yeah, it's so interesting. Everyone lost it.
It was beautiful. It was like, it was a celebration of a man who's truly made a difference. And if you told me that I was gonna say that 5 years ago, I would have slapped you in the face.
But that was the thing that made me laugh, because, gosh, he was a little harsh on you.
Yeah. And he told me I looked, I think he called me a fat Jonah Hill looking girl.
Not that bad, not that bad. No, that's not that bad.
Jonah Hill's attractive.
Exactly. But you have the confidence and that's how fun you are to come out, and you told him that back to his face, and then you said, Beth, your wife is so lucky. You are so lucky to have Beth for a wife.
I mean,
because he looks like...
I think I said he looks like a cartoon of a female Jewish horse. Thank you.
Oh my goodness, that made me laugh. I've never heard of that reference in my life.
Thank you.
But it somehow works. And
I'm so glad. It was really, I really care about Howard. Like, I really think he's like a voice for important causes. I think he's an outspoken feminist. And again, these are words. I'm like, what am I saying? Who am I?
But it is kind of, yeah.
Yes, he's one of the people who really speaks out on issues that matter to me and matter to a lot of women. Yeah. And I think that we should be thankful that he's in the world.
I agree. I love this.
This is the same man who, like, you know, brought the Sibian to the radio. And I can't talk about what that is on this TV show. It's vulgar.
Okay, I didn't get the reference, but I assume
it's sexual.
Okay, good. All right, yeah, I didn't get to that chapter yet.